So good morning, dear student. As you all know is that yesterday we have done up to concatenation, like joining of more than one strings. String means like text values. So this is the only formula we can apply to the text values, addition only, and that addition can be done by the help of AND operator. It is given in front of you. This one is AND operator. And how you can write it, yesterday I have explained. Let me revise again to you. If we will write without any space, then directly you have to start double quotes, write first letter, first word, double quotes close, then AND operator, then double quotes start, then second number, second value, then double quotes close. When you will press enter key, both the words will be joined together. This is string concatenation. If you want to give space in between, then you have to give space within double quotes. Let me give an example. Given here in front of you in your screen. Here it is. I want to write I love computer. And I want one space in between each word. So for doing that, what I will do? Double quote start, one space. Then I, then one space, double quotes close, then AND operator, then double quote start, love, then space, then double quote close, then AND, again double quote start, one space, computer, one space, double quote close. So in within double quotes with each word, we will give one space. So in output also you will see, each letter, each word will come with one space only, like I, one space, love, one space and computer. So up to here we have done yesterday. So now we are continuing with our class with a fresh topic. So let me start our class. I hope my screen and sound is visible to you all. If any problem is there, write in chat. I am keep watching the chat also. Okay. So let me start, Peter.
Let us talk about using a range in a formula. You can assign multiple cells to a formula by creating a reference or a range. Use of a range saves a lot of time. Time for the fact file. A range spans a cell or a group of cells adjacent to each other on a worksheet. The range can be used in formulas. For example, if you want to calculate the sum of columns or rows, it is always better to define a range. Type the data as shown in the figure. Click on the cell B11 and type the formula equal to sum bracket in B4 is to B9 bracket close. Press the enter key. The sum value will be displayed in the cell B11. Similarly, calculate sum in the cell C11. Let us take a quick view. 11 and type the formula equal to sum bracket in B4 is to B9 bracket close.
Now look at here, beta, we have taken the sum. When we talk about sum, it means we are taking more than one cells together, but those cells should be in continuous series. Like here we are taking the numbers which are in cells B4, B5, B6, B7, B8, B9. So in place of writing all the cell names and adding a plus sign in between, plus operator in between, we can use this as a range of the cells. For doing that, in place of operator we have to use function. And in yesterday's class, I told you that sum is a function. So sum function we will use for addition. Then in bracket, we will assign range values. Range value mean starting value and the last value. In between values, it will consider automatically. Like B4 to B9. So in between B5, B6, B7, B8, all these values will be considered automatically. And all these value will be added to the cell where you have written the formula. Like this one is the cell where you have written the formula. After writing this, when you will press enter key, then sum of all the numbers will be displayed here like this.
Press the enter key.
Look at here, this is the value of our sum of all these numbers. This will be the answer. So this way we can use range in a formula.
The sum value will be displayed in the cell B11. Similarly, calculate sum in the cell C11. Let us take a quick view. To enter or modify a formula in a cell, you can also press F2 after selecting the cell. Alright students, now let me give you a tip. Range basically shortens the length of the formula. For example, if you wish to add values from B4 to B9, you can either write as equal to sign sum bracket in B4, B5, B6, B7, B8, B9.
But it is saying that you can write in this way also, but no one prefers this thing because it's very difficult to write all the cell names inside the function. Then what is the use of function? Directly we can write this way also, equal to B4 plus B5 plus B6 plus B7. Directly we can write this way, but basically the this thing function is used for using the range in the cells. Okay, beta. So it is showing another way of writing the function, but no one prefers this.
Bracket close or equal to sign sum bracket in B4 colon B9 bracket close.
This is the most preferred way, beta. Equal to sum B4 to B9 means range of the cell from starting cell to the last cell.
Bracket close. Let us discuss about types of cell references. The cell address is the formula is known as the cell reference. For example, A1, B6, etc., where A denotes the column name and 1 denotes the row number. With reference, you can use the data from different parts of the worksheet. There are 3 types of cell references.
Beta, before reading about the cell references, as I explained yesterday also, let me repeat. References means in place of taking value. In place of taking value, we are taking cell number like A1, A2, A3. We are taking these. Like A1 cell contain value 1000. A2 cell contain value 2000 and A3 cell contain 4000 value. So while adding these cells, one thing we can write is equal to 1000 plus 2000 plus 4000. This we can write. But if we are using referencing, then in place of taking the values, we will take their cell name like equal to A1 plus A2 plus A3. Means these are the references. We are taking reference of the cell, not the value of the cell. So let me read about the different types of cell references.
Let us discuss about relative versus absolute cell reference. Relative reference. When you create a formula, references to a cell or ranges are usually based on the position relative to the cell. When you copy or move the formula to other cells, the reference cell automatically gets changed. For example, if the formula in A3 is equal to A1 plus A2, and when you copy the formula from A3 to B3, Excel automatically changes the reference to match the location of cells, that is equal to sign B1 plus B2. Follow these steps. Select the cell B11 in which formula equals to sum bracket in B4 colon B9 bracket close is written. Click on the copy button. Select C11. Click on the paste button. Note that C11 has a cell reference from C4 to C9 instead of B4 to B9. Okay, students, an interesting fact. The easiest way to define names for cells is to... Okay, students, an interesting fact. B11 in which formula equals to sum, bracket in B4, colon B9, bracket close is written. Click on the copy button. Select C11. Click on the paste button. Note that C11 has a cell reference from...
Now look at here, beta. I want to show you one thing. Like, we have written a formula in this cell, that is cell B11, and the formula which we have written is equal to sum bracket start, and range we have started from B4 to B9, okay, and then bracket close. When we have pressed enter key, then you will see sum of all these numbers coming from B4 to B9 is in the cell B11. But if you talk about like same thing which we are copying, like I am copying the cell B11 and then pasting it into the C11, then you will found it will copy only the formula, it doesn't copy the value. Understand? And when you will click on this cell and check in formula bar, like this is our formula bar, then you will see in place of B4 to B9 in formula, it automatically gets changed C4 to C9. Okay, so in this beta, in C11, it is showing the sum of values from C4 to C9. Okay, 200 plus 100 plus 300 plus 250 plus 175 plus 275. When you add these numbers, the result will be 1300 only. So this is reference, means in place of copying the value, it is copying the formula, whatever we have entered in the previous cell. And the range of the cells will be automatically get changed according to the column. Previous one was column B. That's why formula was B4 to B9. Here we have copied that into this column C. So the formula automatically gets changed from B4 to B9 to C4 to C9. And the value will also get changed according to the formula. Clear now, beta? So let we continue our topic, beta. Beta, in chat, everyone have the freedom to raise their question. Don't say that what is your problem, this is simple one. No, you don't allow to do that thing. Everyone can ask question, whether it is a simplest one or anything. Okay? And no one hesitate to ask question, beta. My chat window is also open. I am looking at your chat. Okay? So let we continue with our topic, everyone.
A reference from C4 to C9 instead of B4 to B9. Okay, students, an interesting fact. The easiest way to define names for cells is to click on the name box at the left end of formula bar. Type a name for the range and press enter. Now the second type of cell reference is absolute reference. Absolute reference is used when we do not want to change the address of the cell on copying the formula to another cell. To make absolute reference of a formula, add dollar sign before the column and row number equal to $A, $1 plus $A, $2 is an example of absolute reference. Students, we can quickly get the total of adjacent cells by pressing Alt plus equal key combination instead of clicking. Yes. Type 10% in the cell D1 before the column and row number. equal to dollar A, dollar 1 plus dollar A, dollar 2. Isn't it?
Look at here, beta, when we talk about absolute reference. If you want to give absolute reference, you must use dollar sign before row number as well as the column name. Okay? Like our column name is A and the row number is 1, so the cell name is A1. So while writing thing in absolute reference, you must use dollar with both the things, like dollar A means dollar before column name, then dollar 1, dollar before row number. Likewise in second also, dollar A, dollar 2. Beta, dollar sign tells that this is an absolute reference. If it doesn't use dollar, like directly if we are writing A1, it means it is a relative reference. That's why dollar we have to use. And what is the use of it, like why we are using absolute reference, we will see in example. When example will come, that I will explain to you. Let me continue, beta. So here from this window you have to remember, for writing absolute reference, you have to use dollar sign before column name and row number.
Is an example of absolute reference. Students, we can quickly get the total of adjacent cells by pressing Alt plus equal key combination instead of clicking auto sum button.
Look at here, beta. So this is the easiest method. I don't want to explain you, but here it's come in front of you, then I have to explain, because I want you to use the sum, do the addition with the help of formula and function only. So let me tell you the easiest way also. Like if you want to add the rows or the columns which are adjacent to each other, then what you have to do, you have to select the rows or the columns which you want to add, select it together, select the range, and after selecting the range, in next cell you have to use this one, Alt plus equal to, then directly result will come next to the cell or the row or the column. So this is the shortcut key for auto sum, Alt plus equal to. All three keys you have to press together and you will get the result of addition of all the numbers.
Let us calculate the incentive at the rate of 10% on monthly sales. Type 10% in the cell D1.
Here, look at this example carefully, everyone. This is the example of absolute reference. Look at here. Don't busy in chat, dear. Look on your screen, try to understand the things.
Click on cell D4. Type B4 into dollar D, dollar 1, and press the enter key. The cell D4 displays the value 100. The first cell address has no dollar sign. So it is relative reference, and the second cell address is fully absolute. Therefore, when the cell is copied, the first one will change the reference in the new location, but second will remain the same, that is dollar D, dollar 1.
Now look at here, Akansa, you were asking, what is the use of dollar sign? That I told you that dollar sign is used for absolute reference. Now what is the meaning of absolute reference? Like basically, if I have written here equal to B2 plus C2, this I have written here, then after that if I will drag it, automatically value will get changed according to the reference. In next cell it will automatically take B3 plus C3, then B4 plus C4, automatically its value gets changed. But if you will use as an absolute reference, value of that cell doesn't change. Here you will see in formula what we have written. I am moving it backward. If you will see, here we have written 10% in cell D1. This is the cell D1. okay, this one, and here we have written 10%, and then after that in formula we will make this cell D1 as an absolute reference, means whose value doesn't get changed when we will drag for calculating the things.
Click on cell D4. Type B4 into $D$1 and press the enter.
Now look at here on the screen. Manikaran, Vaibhav, Siddharth, Harsh, leave the chat now. No one will do anything in chat. Look at your screen and hear me what I am telling you. Yes, Pita. This is very important topic going on. Yes, Pita. Here we have used two types of references in a single cell. One is like, look at this formula where my cursor is there, pointer is there, mouse pointer, equal to B4, then multiplication $D$1, means the cell D1 we have made as an absolute reference, because you will see dollar sign we have used with column name as well as row number. So $D$1, it means when we will drag it, B4 will be changes according to the column or row number. Like in next cell it will automatically come B5, then B6, then B7, but this D1 will not change, it will remain the same. Like in next cell also $D$1 will come, then next to next also $D$1 will come, and value will also remain the same of this cell. So what is the 10% of 1000? Give me answer in chat. 10% of 1000. I'm waiting for your response in chat. Yes, the answer is 100. Very good. Now next one, if I talk about what is the 10% of 15,000, tell me fast. 10% of 15,000, you not have to calculate, do it fast. Yes, it's 15. No, it's not 15. Yes, it's 150. So the correct answer is 150, not 1500. It should be 150. And what will be the 10% for 3000? 10% for 3000. Oh, 10%, my dear, we are not multiplying with a 10. Yes, 10% of 3000 is what? 300. And the 10% of 15,000 also 1500, not 150. We were incorrect at that time. 1500 was the correct one. Okay, 10% of 15,000 is 1500. So why I am asking from you? Because when you will expand this formula by the help of this autofill button, when you will drag it, then all these numbers will come here, means the value of $D and $1 remains the same, it doesn't change because it is an absolute reference. So here what the outcome came, that the value of absolute reference doesn't change while copying the formula. In previous time you have seen, when we are copying the formula, value of the cell automatically changed according to the column, but here value remains the same. When you will copy this formula, wherever you are copying it, the value of B4 will get changed, $D$1 will remain the same. This is absolute reference. Clear to everyone? Yes, absolute reference is clear. Write in chat. Okay, very good, beta. Now we are moving to our next topic. We are continuing our video.
Press the enter key. The cell D4 displays the value 100. The first cell address has no dollar sign. So it is relative reference and the second cell address is fully absolute. Therefore, when the cell is copied, the first one will change the reference in the new location, but second will remain the same, that is $D$1. Now copy the formula when the pointer changes to a copy pointer symbol. Drag the selected formula to the rest of the cells. The third type of cell reference is mixed reference. It is a combination of relative and absolute reference. In this type of reference, either row or column has to remain fixed. $A1 plus $A2 is an example of mixed.
Look at here, beta, as the name suggests, mixed reference means mixture of both of two, like absolute as well as what? Relative, both the references. Here you will see in the first value, look at my mouse pointer, everyone. Here in the first value, it is written $A1, and in second value, it is written $A2. Here you will see we have made constant to the column only, column name only. Like A is the column name and we have used dollar sign before it. So the value of column will remain the same and the value of row will be changed accordingly. Like the formula we are copying to the next cell, then column name will remain the same and the row number will be changed. Like $A2, $A3, $A5, $A6. This way. And while we talk about the second one, $A2, here the value of row number will remain the same. It will take second row only, but column name will be changed. Like if we are copying this formula to the next column, like C, D, E, F, here we are copying. So the value of column will be changed, like $C2. $D2, $E2, $F2. Okay, whether you are copying it into the row number 4, but still it will take value of row number 2 only, but the column number will be changed. So this is the mixed reference where we are mixing both the references. Like column we are taking as a relative and row we are taking as a absolute, or row as a taking as a absolute and column taking as a relative. So this is the mixed reference, beta.
It's an example of mixed reference. For example, let us calculate the actual monthly expenses. Type 50 in cell D2. Click on cell E4. Type $C4 minus $D2. Press the enter key. You can calculate the actual expenses of other cells by dragging the mouse pointer to rest of the cells.
Beta, this way you can do all the things. Like in first cell you have to write the formula and that formula will be applied to the other cells. This is our fill handle. It comes when you are selecting any cell. On the right hand side at the bottom of the cell you will see one small plus sign is there, very tiny symbol is there of plus. That is autofill button. Press that autofill button and drag your mouse to the next range of cells and you will see automatically that formula will be applied to other cells also and result will come automatically. So we are continuing it. Beta, we will do up to mixed reference only. I also know how much is the time. Don't remind me again and again.
Of the cells, when pointer changes to a copy pointer symbol. Students, to calculate the sum of multiple cells that are not in a range, separate each cell address by comma. For example, equals to sum bracket in C4, C6, D8. Bracket close.
Beta, this function is used for, mainly made for this thing only. Like, you are taking cells that is not in continuously, not in a continuous series. Like, one cell is C4, one is C6, one is D8. Means, they are at the different location. So, for that, you have to write their cell names. Instead of writing the range, you have to write the cell names. Remember this thing.
Bracket close. Okay, students, now let me give you a tip. Range names are not case sensitive. The first character must be a letter, an underscore, or a black slash. The range name must not be same as a cell address.
Now look at here, beta. Case sensitive means if you are writing the same thing in smalls or you are writing the same thing in capital, that will be considered as same if it is not case sensitive. So here it is saying it is not case sensitive. So whether you are writing cell name as small b1 or capital b1, both will be considered as the same thing.
All right, we will learn about cell reference of another worksheet.
But this topic we will do tomorrow, as the time is about to over. So I hope you all have enjoyed the lecture and learned a lot. So you all knows what is your homework. You have to do these topics practically in your laptop. So now I am taking your doubt. So our doubt session begins. So write in which topic you are having doubt. I am looking at your chat window and I will clear your doubts. Yes, beta, ask.